Are we starting?
I think so.
No, we're starting. Let's lose this finals.
Let's go.
Double shield. Bowser, Cloud.
I go. The Cloud just kind of starts off by ducking there. Just kind of starting. Now, last time these guys played, like, literally like 30 minutes ago, Devin and Munoz won.
I wish we won. We'd be
my,
here.
My good God. I was looking at the names and not the characters. Dyren West won.
Devin, we won, right?
Okay.
We got them. Anyway, Lemon on deck.
You know, West is kind of scared of that Lemon. He just kind of throws it out there. It's like he can get away with throwing it out in doubles.
Yeah. It's like a guy with a loaded shotgun just walking around just slowly. Like, is it my turn yet, boss?
Yeah. It's like, I'm ready. Well, Dill just already died.
Yeah, Big Bubba's on the screen, just like sitting on people.
Like, look out, he's gonna ground pound you, throw my big sword at you.
He's like, I got it, both.
And like I've been saying earlier, this is definitely team technical versus team go ham.
Team just like, I'm gonna kill you.
Yeah, I'm gonna kill you
if
at
you
like
mess up,
30.
I will kill you. I will sit on you if you sit there. Don't sit there.
Yeah, and you know, any other character that F Smash probably would have like did the job, but like, Dyer is, Bowser with that 130 weight, dude.
Yeah. They're keeping it pretty even, though. It was pretty even before when they were playing earlier.
Yeah, it was. It was super even. It was 2-1. Unfortunately, I Sage did SD in the last game. Kind of just dropped the spaghetti everywhere.
No. I thought to myself, like...
Yeah, what'd you think?
Double Sheik in teams? I don't think that's kind
did
of...
Did you see that?
What?
Like, okay, so like he did an up throw to Dill. And
he went down.
Right? No, I'm sorry. He did an up throw to Sage. And Dill was in the middle of it, and it set at the weirdest angle to the bottom left. That was the craziest thing.
Smash Bros.
I've never seen that.
It happens.
I'm sure Dill's like, I can only imagine how mad Dill is from that. Like, it's just like, I just died from the stupidest thing.
Dill doesn't get mad, he just shrugs it off.
Yeah.
Goes, okay. Sage would be like, what the hell?
Yeah.
And then like, he would just tell us off screen.
Yeah.
But I don't know about Double Sheik. Like, I didn't think that was like a really good team. Uh-huh. Then I played it. I played against it. It's just like, wow.
That raw F Smash.
Like, it's really pressuring.
Yeah, it's like it's because like they can't kill you.
They can't kill you, but they will make me off stage.
They will make you feel like you can't push any button.
No. That's the thing. Like, it's Sheik. She just comes in. She's like, oh no, you're not playing. What did I do?
Yeah.
I feel like I let them get away with it like, a few times though.
That was
like the double jump fairs though.
Did you see
it?
Oh
wow.
Oh no, no, oh my God.
You let that happen.
I thought Dill was gonna land in there and get hit by that F smash. Oh, good thing he took that to the left. Earlier I saw a little exchange where like Wes went for an up smash, mm-hmm. but then missed because Dill went for an up B, so he like ducked underneath it before he went off. It was kinda cute.
Yeah. Team Dynasty over here.
Yeah.
Up smashes on deck. That misses, they got a bouncing push.
Uh-huh.
Or explosion. Either way, they're really good at keeping each other like, you know, covered when it comes to like certain situations.
They tend to like these 1v1 situations in doubles too. They try to make it 2v1v1.
Yeah.
As you can see right here, that's what they go for. Whereas Dyer and West kind of like want to stay together.
Right.
So they can get away with more shenanigans.
Yeah, they don't want like Bowser to like get hit for 20 billion damage for trying to land against these two, because you know he is gonna get hit like here. It's like fair is gonna hit him, back air is gonna hit him, four tilt, you name it.
Man, Dyer just kind of like not. Oh my God, he just
not
killed
caring.
Everyone except.
It's a 1v1 now. Don't get grabbed.
Yeah, Dyer was literally just like, I want this to be a 1v1 now.
He's like, hold on, let me flip the switch.
Oh, hoo-ha, though. They patched that out though. They patched that out.
No, it's not patched out. At around that percentage, it still works.
Yeah, and he landed it. Yo, look at Dyron's.
That was game Dyer right there. He
yeah,
just took
Dyer
control
was
the
just
whole
like,
thing.
I'm gonna kill all three of you now. Bye.
He's like, no, it's my turn to play. I came
He's
back.
Like, listen, we've been having
all your top.
Yeah,
players.
We've been having these stage control issues between all four of us. It's my stage. It's not Wes's stage. It's my stage.
It's like a switch that he just had like right there under the stairs. Like
on, he had it on deck, dude. Swap it, done deal.
Oh, let's go. Game two.
They're probably going to go back to FD. That's what they did last time anyways.
Hope the blue team isn't rattled from that.
I mean, you know, Dill, as you said earlier, doesn't really get flustered all. Dill is probably one of the most neutral people whenever he's playing. Sage, however, I can see Sage getting on tilt a little
bit. Yeah, but Sage can also, like, you know, use that tiltness, like...
To actually play better.
Yeah.
which is a superpower for it. And of course, yes, they do go back to FD. They prefer this when fighting against these heavies.
Oh, this sandwich is nice.
They don't want to die to like absurd percents on the top platform. No, there's no platform for them to deal with.
Yeah, what a traitor percent right there.
Yeah.
Surprised they didn't pick up platform. Oh, yeah, it's because Bowser.
It's because Bowser's side.
Yeah, Bowser's on the team, and he's just like, he's going to get juggled all day.
Yeah.
Not going to land.
And also, like, with the platforms, like, if he gets that Bowser side on the top platform, you're going to die at an absurd percent. Ooh, Dill just kind of walked off throughout that better.
Okay, just letting him get limited.
It's like, whatever, just going to let you waste it.
Yeah, dude, keep your ass off stage. Oh. Good thing he was safe after that, because that would have been really risky. Also, part of the thing was, like, fighting
Bowser Bomb's teammate.
Fighting a team of like two of the same characters, when they pick like close to similar colors, it's hard to tell which one
to
do which.
No, like, it's, I wasn't really as a commentator, it confuses me too.
Yeah.
Especially with their names, because now they both start with a D, like on stage.
So I gotta look at tags now.
Yeah.
Thankfully, everyone uses tags here.
Yeah, I mean, earlier it was S Tails versus D Tails, so it was a little bit easier.
Yeah.
But now it's like D and D. Who's that in there? So yeah, you got West landing down there and Dill covering it with a down smash. Interesting enough, last patch, Sheik's down smash did get buffed.
Yeah.
It kills like 2% earlier.
By a significant.
It's like
a slight significant.
Yeah, it's like not even, no one cares.
Yeah.
Not even the Sheik's care.
Not even the Sheik's. They're like,
I don't think it has yet determined a game.
Like fast fall, down smash, that's cute.
Yeah. So whenever I see a Sheik use down smash, I'm like, oh, they're using the bombs.
Yeah.
Wow, that was nice. I like that. He was caught in the middle of jab, so he ran up there and did the dynasty.
Oh.
Dire, please. That man was charging for something. Something ridiculous, something scary.
I'm just waiting for that one Bowser bomb to happen that'll just change the momentum of the match.
Yeah.
Like, something like that's gonna happen.
Dire has the ability with Bowser to just completely change the match with one button. But he just has to wait for the correct opportunity.
Yeah. West does too because, you know, he's Cloud.
Oh,
he's
good edge guarding from Dill.
He's not letting him take
this. This is looking like a blowout. Is he not going to take the stock? That's
all
not
right.
Going to kill.
All right.
That will, though. I can see why he didn't take the stock there because they probably feel better with West with a 1v2 situation. But then it's like they got 5 stocks. Like,
yeah.
This is one of those times where I would not like berate someone for killing themselves now, just to like go on to game 3, because what's happening right now is you're gonna lose momentum. You're gonna get in this bad state where you're like, nothing's working, I'm in a bad situation, it's an uphill battle. So sometimes I would agree with just like killing yourself playing the game 3. If this is last game, never, you know, like you might as well keep playing it out. But because you still have another game after this, this is best 3 of 5, so you have a ton of games. So why kill your momentum? Or maybe, you know, maybe Weston knows something.
No, I remember something Devin always says, it's like, whenever you're in a situation like this, use this as data for the next time you play it.
Mm, that as well.
Like, even if it's the losing set.
I like to call it the classic anti. What anti would do in singles is play, like, wonky characters first. That footstool.
Yeah.
Dirty. But, like, anti would use, like, random characters in the first set. Like, he'd be in Grand Finals, and first set he would use random characters to collect data. Mm-hmm. Then second set he goes all Mario.
Yeah.
That's what he did against, Ninja Link.
Yeah.
Ninja Link's Bayonetta, when Bayonetta first came out. He went random characters against him first set, then second set is like all Mario. When we interviewed him afterwards, he's like, yeah, that was all data.
Yeah. There are players out there that are just good at...
good at collecting data.
Yeah. Just doing that. It's like, alright, I'll mess around for a bit.
And then there's characters...
like, secretly in the back of their mind, they're just downloading it.
And then there's players who are really good at taking notes, like the Buzz. Like, that dude.
Yeah.
Like,
guy has a
notes?
Phone full of notes.
Yeah. He has so many notes, it's crazy. I wish I could even think to make that many notes on a character. Player.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever. Yo, Jash in the building, though.
Oh, it's good, Jash.
Yo, we're looking slick with
Toon
that
Link.
Coat.
What a character.
What a character.
What a character.
What a savior.
Yeah.
He'll time us all out. All
right, game three.
I mean, he'll play good with those up smashes. Not time us out. That's not what Toon Link's about.
Could you time us out? Could you time out?
Toon Link? He says, yes, of course. Of course, it's Toon Link. Toon Link times people out ever since Brawl days. Come on, man.
Show me.
Show me.
if we play, show me. Oh, I feel it. All right, game 3.
Dire starts off the match with a Bowser Bomb. this
Why not?
It's like, whatever. He
it's
flash
like,
one, I guess.
The flash happens, and you're just like, all right, pay attention to something on the screen right now. Hope it's this.
It reminds me of when Numbers, like, respawns with Shulk and just backslash immediately.
Yeah.
Like, sometimes you can just get away with those wonky moves right out of the respawn shield. But that was, like, the beginning of the match.
Ooh. You know, platform stations could also be a good thing for these guys, because, you know, shield break setups.
Man, Bowser's pivot grab goes forever.
Oh.
He caught him and like brought him in with his like telepathic force. And
yeah, just suction cup right in his hands.
I like what Dire went for there with that up smash, but it just came out a little bit too late.
What?
That's one of the things where it's like you kind of hesitate because you grab your partner, but the best thing to do is just throw him immediately, just
yeah.
to get out of that situation.
Yeah, you also get like the little invincibility while you throw him too.
Yeah. Whereas if you wait there, it gives your teammates time to. That is the third time I've seen Sage DI, or SD,
yeah.
since I started commentating
Dill
today.
Surprisingly got out of that situation, now he just has to hold stock, you know.
God.
Charge needles, throw him, stay away. These characters will kill you off touch.
Got him kind of the corner there. I thought for sure Dyer was going to go for a bomb.
Yeah, right there.
He was like
I was
in the prime point. Wow,
he's like, I'm going to sit on this ledge real quick. Oh, you're right there?
Yeah, see ya. I like that use of the up smash from Sage. Wow, catch him with that up B.
Yeah, the jab kept him there in place. It's pretty good.
Once
again,
it happened again.
Wow.
And okay. It was to Dill once again, but Dill, realizing it this time, was able to recover, had his double jumps still. Last time he like accidentally used his double jump somewhat into the wall, he was getting caught, so he could not recover.
Makes me think of like something interesting about like using throws in teams, like especially like using the mid animation throw in order to like send people weird like distances and stuff. Like for example, like Meta Knight's up throw, the explosion at the bottom, that kills.
Yup. Collins and singles matches in the background.
So if you don't think
those guys were both off stage trying to kill each other.
Yeah.
If neither of them cared about recovering, they're just like, no, we're gonna hit each other. One of us is dying.
Good blocks, good throw.
You got the King Kong Koopa going here. King Kong.
Up smash again, you're not gonna punish it.
Nah. Dyer's at a very scary percent. Never mind.
That fire burst was so risky.
Mm-hmm. Once again, it's one of those moves where you cover your front with your character like Sheik or Zero, so you can just use that arc to get across it.
Yeah. So red team's slightly in the lead right here with stocks. But if Dyer keeps getting juggled like this and dies...
Yeah, he is stuck between a rock and a hard place
there. That's a share stock that's gonna happen. Good scoops.
That raw up smash.
It's like, wait a second.
Ooh, Dyer's living though. And he still keeps his limit. That's very important that he keeps that as much as he can. He's able to do more combos with that.
Just hold right, hold left. Hold towards the stage.
Yeah.
Keep it on you. Oh, wow.
Wow. Dyer just goes with a sneaky... Oh, my God. That kill. Killing Bowser at like, kind of an absurd percent. He's going to decide opt to go for that stock.
Those
you know, help out his
really
teammate.
With that. And
maybe
he still gets
his he saw that he was at a prime percent for the Koopa to work. Or the Bow Wow, or whatever you want to call it.
I call it the Showtime.
Showtime. I like that.
Showtime.
Showtime.
Oh.
There it is. Done.
Oh, that should have been done, Wes. Wake up, Wes.
Doesn't matter.
There you go.
Wow, that tilt killed.
That still looks like he's doing all the work, though.
These guys, like, losing their...
These guys are clowns.
Yeah, no, they are, dude.
They're like,
I love watching these dudes play on doubles, because it's like, we don't play this game as much as these guys do, and we're just like...
Yeah, they got good teamwork out there.
They got good teamwork. Their synergy is through the roof.
It's amazing.
I mean, they've been the same crew since, like, 2003.
Playing forever.
Yeah. So, Dylan Sage has got
I got to match the play. But
you do?
Call something else.
Whew.
Nervous.
He's not responding.
My God.
Call something else!
All right, game four. Back to FD. These guys want these OTs. They don't want to give them platforms again, you know?
Wow, Dyer just used three uppies in a row. This man.
Scramble right now, dude. It's
Oh, Wes is going to catch him with that down smash. Sorry, I was distracted by Devin.
Yeah.
That was funny. So, wow, Wes just kind of falling down there and throwing out that bear. Not caring that his teammate was there.
Yeah.
I saw that they were going for a setup there, and because it took too long to figure out that setup, like, we got Dire capitalizing on that. That's one of the things. When you're in a team, your setups have to be on point. You can't, yeah. You can't take, if, the second you take a second to think about what you're going to do, the opponents are going to capitalize on
it. Yeah, you're going to hurt your partner, too.
Yeah. Like, so that's exactly what happened.
Things happen like that.
Yeah. It's like, things are going, like...
Yeah, they got to practice that.
Yeah. Like, things are going super fast in doubles.
Difference between people who actually, you know, practice their setups. People who actually, you know, know
I mean,
each
this,
other.
This is the same... this is, like, one of the first times Dylan Sage have teamed in a long time.
Oh, yeah, so, definitely.
You know, they're obviously a little shaky.
I believe they were practicing yesterday.
Yep.
Should be kill. Should have been
Ooh.
Kill.
Doesn't quite get what he wants. Wow, Dire just runs up there, goes for a grab. He's like, I don't care who I grab, I'm grabbing someone.
Yeah.
Someone is getting into my grips.
Good up, man, right there.
That was very interesting. We got the side beat from Dill hitting Wes while he had the invincibility. And so he, like, bounced off the invincibility, and then Wes punished it.
Yeah. Getting in there.
Ooh, we got some nairs.
Keep him off him.
I'm liking what Wes does with his dares. Like, he, like, uses the dare to hit the touch the shield and then lands behind him so he doesn't get grabbed. Or in, like, kind of, like, a little bit away. So, you know, very optimal spacing. You know, it's basic Glad stuff, but it's just refreshing to see regardless.
Yeah. It's really important.
Ooh. I'll do that. Trying to go for that dash grab, but Dire ends up spot dodging it.
That was close. Getting away from that ledge when Bowser's on is really
good. Wow. Nice. That was such good awareness from Dire. Like, knowing that, like, oh, that nair hit, I'm going to follow this up with that bear.
Do you think this team has trouble killing right now?
The sheep team?
Yeah.
Yeah. That seems to be, like, the greatest, like, flaw of this team.
Yeah, their communication's not...
Also, their synergy is not quite there either. I don't think their synergy is, like, the best it could be.
That was...
I guess Adil was thinking Sage was going to, like, throw him at that exact moment, or, like, Adil thought he was close enough or something, but it just nothing connected. And once again, Dire just ran in there going, like, oh, Bowser, and just, like, interrupted everything.
Yeah, they're up stocks. They really don't care at this point.
He just hit Sage with that very, very avoidable side B.
Yeah, Paige unfortunately didn't avoid it.
Yeah, so you definitely tell the momentum.
Needles in the fish. Let's go, Adil.
Yeah. Dill's not losing momentum. I can definitely sense Sage is playing a little bit sloppier.
Alright, down to even stocks.
Look at these ninjas just jumping.
Yeah, they're trying to be really safe against these two right now.
I saw that Wes went for the fair on his teammate because he wanted to get his teammate a little bit more rage and he wanted to get his limit break.
Yeah.
So, like, very optimal. Ooh, that dash attack?
Ooh.
Once again, Dire, like, with those follow-ups. Wow, that was
so you
like...
keep tossing them, I'll keep bringing them
out. That was just the most random F-smash. They weren't even close, but I guess he thought maybe they're going to charge in.
He's like, get him out of here. Yeah. All right, I got you.
Uh-oh.
Dead.
I can't even tell there's a lot. It's Sage, okay, so... Yeah.
Bowser goes in, he gets the grab.
Sage has got to get, like, oh my god.
Yeah.
This is just... If Sage can just kill one of them right now...
He has to.
That's the problem, is that he can't.
Don't SD? Yeah, he SD.
And he SD. That's number four I've seen today.
Well, that was it.
Did you know that four SDs is the equivalent of a set? A best 2 of 3?
You're right.
So, in the past hour of casting, I've seen him SD four times. Like, Sage is playing a little bit sloppy today. I guess he just has to wake up. I mean...